Evidence of God in DNA itself. Lecture 4. In the previous lecture, I have related the ladder of Jacob of the Bible to the Watson Crick ladder of biology and demonstrated that the ladder is the archetype of life at the soul level. The purpose of this lecture is to relate the symbol S of the Christogram, I plus HSO, to the spiral pattern of DNA, as I have related the symbol H of the Christogram to the ladder. It presents evidences to reveal that the spiral pattern of DNA belongs to a universal series of spirals with archetypal links to life at the psyche level. Of which there are innumerable examples. I shall cite only a few of such examples in this lecture. A well-known instance of life power lying cold in word form is the serpent power or Kundalini. According to Vedic scholars, the subtle body of the Kundalini consists of 50 letters or sound powers of the Sanskrit alphabet. All descriptions in various texts on Kundalini tally well with the concept of DNA as a coil of code words. In man, Kundalini exists in two states, that is, latent and aroused. Both these states afford comparison with the DNA coiling patterns, which I am relating to psyche level of yielding of consciousness in this lecture. We shall start with the latent serpent power. In the latent state, Kundalini exists at the base of the human spine, that is Muladhara Chakra, coiled in 3.4 coils around a rod-like Shivalinga, as shown in figure 3 below, on page 26. Comparison of the latent serpent with the double helix provides the following points of interest. 1. The serpent coiled around the rod-like Shivalinga compares with the double helix coiled around its central axis. 2. The 3.4 angstrom distance between base pairs, that is steps of a ladder in DNA, and 3.4 nanometers length of the central axis in one turn of the helix, earlier called the helix zone. This compares with the 3.4 coils of Kundalini around the rod-like Shivalinga. 3. The body of the Kundalini consisting of 50 letters or sound powers of the Sanskrit language compares with the subtle body of DNA as a coil of code words, that is the alphabetic skeleton of DNA as it may be seen. 4. This reveals that the patterns and related numerics of DNA as physical basis of life conform to the patterns and numerics of psyche or the psychic energy called the serpent power, that again is a coiled power. Knowledge on life gained through science here tallies with the wisdom of Vedic seers on life power. Coming to the aroused state of the serpent power, it is associated with the heightening of consciousness beyond its accustomed limits. This state of arousal is pictured through a variety of ancient symbols, in all of which we see serpentine coils as in the double helix, as shown in the figures 3-2, comparison of the double helix, Kundalini and the Caduceus, and also through figures 6-7-AB, which are symbolic pictures of the three serpents of Eden, and also the serpent in the Kabbalistic tree. All of these relate to the coiled Kundalini power, also called the serpent power. Now there are various other examples of which I shall mention about the laminin cross and the crosier. I have earlier referred to the laminin in relation to its Latin cross configuration. Here it is shown to reveal its double helical chain B1 and B2 in figure 3B. 3B, on page 28, as compared to the plus and minus strands of DNA, and its A chain compared to the central axis of DNA helix. The cross here with the double serpents is a complex icon of regenerated life, also called the tree of life in church circles. I have elsewhere presented a detailed lecture on the crosier, which you can refer. Its comparison with the double helix provides further proof for the scientific basis of this ancient symbol of the church. Now I shall come to the chokurei and the sacramental signs of the church. The chokurei is a power symbol used in Reiki. It starts in a horizontal line corresponding to the Reiki source, which runs into a vertical line ending in spirals, which symbolize the energy flow as shown in the figure. The spiral touches the middle line 7 times, representing the 7 chakras through which the aroused psychic energy rises. Traditionally, chokurei is drawn anti-clockwise. Some prefer to draw it clockwise, as this is said to work better for them. This, they say, seems more logical. The chokurei is not only a symbol of the spiral energy field, but also has the associated number 3.4 of coils, which is shared with the latent serpent power 3.4 coils on the one hand and with the DNA helix on the other, that is 3.4 angstrong distance between bases. These may be called to be numerically archetypal. I shall come later to the numerical archetypes in DNA to add to these data, which brings science and religion together in the concept of life as God and consciousness as fielding in 7 fields, etc. What is stranger still is that the chokurei is also a TA baseline relation. Chokuro has also a TA baseline relation to DNA, as shown in figure 3-4A on page 29. This provides clear indication that the life energy in DNA must be akin to the pranic energy of the chokurei and the serpent power. As life energy, that is consciousness, cannot be characterized physically, its presence can and must be inferred from indirect evidences like those above mentioned. The TA relations of the chokurei has many other parallels, as I have earlier shown in the previous lecture. Now we come to another important example, that is the astral atom. The astral atom, also called UPA, that is ultimate physical atom of theosophy, is a pulsating globule of astral matter seen in inner vision by theosophists. All elements of chemistry, they say, are made of astral atoms, which represent the first stage in the stepping down of consciousness to matter. So it is from consciousness that matter is formed, and consciousness as light. In the beginning was God, and God said, let there be light. So this light refers to consciousness, and it is from consciousness that matter arises. That is how it can be explained in terms of the ideas presented in the book of Genesis. The astral atoms are of two kinds, positive or male and negative or female. These remind the plus and minus strands of DNA with which they further compare in its double helical structure and stranded nature. As can be seen from figure 3.5 on page 30, comparison of astral atom with a BDNA. In fact, Leadbeater, a well-known theosophist, has made a more detailed study of the structure of the UPA. He has found that each of the 10 hertz is a closed helical coil with 1.6820 turns. He claims to have checked this number meticulously by counting the number of turns in a whirl in 135 different UPAs selected from numerous substances. Each circular turn of the whirl or first order spirilla is another helix made of 7 smaller circular turns or second order spirillae, and so on. Seventh and last order spirally consists of 5 bubbles spaced evenly along the circumference of a circle. Annie Besant and Leadbeater have referred to these as bubbles of Coilion, K-O-I-L-I-O-N, Coilion. The figure 3.5C reproduced above from the 1951 edition of Occult Chemistry gives a schematic presentation of the 5th, 6th and 7th order spirillae of the astral atom, which can be seen as a wave within a wave. It is indeed a unique atom with features common to DNA and so to the principle of life called consciousness, as subtly hidden in DNA, especially in relation to its patterns and content as world. The UPA consists of 10 closed curves, of which 3 are thicker, called major whorls. Each of the 3 major whorls has 2 strands for a total of 6 strands, which converge with the 6 strands on one side of the BDNA shown in figure 3. Now coming back to the macrocosmic and divine aspects of the spiral, it is seen in the Bible as whirlwind instead of the spiral. You find the usage whirlwind in many places. In the Bible there are instances of God appearing in the whirlwind, which indicates a spiral field. God thus spoke to Job in a whirlwind of which the Bible says, then the Lord answered to Job out of the whirlwind and said, who is it that darkeneth counsel by words without knowledge? Job 38:1-2. The astral atom with its worlds is a micro version, as it were, of the whirlwind. In the male, that is plus atom, the pranic force pours in from the astral world. It passes through the atom and out into the physical world. That is what theosophists teach. In the female, the force passes it from the physical world through the atom and out into the astral world, thus vanishing from the physical world. Example number 2 is the word of the Lord that came to Prophet Ezekiel in a whirlwind. The word of the Lord came expressly unto Ezekiel, the priest, the son of Buzi, in the land of the Chaldeans by the river Chebar. And the hand of the Lord was there upon him. And he looked, and behold, a whirlwind came out of the north, a great cloud and fire enfolding it. Ezekiel 1, 3 to 4. Here we find the association of the word, that is word of God, with the spiral, that is whirlwind, which reminds of the DNA code scripts in the coil. That is why DNA is also called the coil of life. And like the Kundalini earlier mentioned, it is a coil of words of life. The spiral patterns indicates the field of the psyche, and the word denote the spirit. An equivalent Vedic concept that describes divine spirals in Parashakti Kundalini or universal creatrix. So you will find that the spiral pattern is repeated in relation to divine life also, as conceived by various religions. Now, apart from the spiral as characteristic pattern or flow of psychic energy, also called psychergy, psychurgy, the spiral is also a universal and ubiquitous pattern, as in DNA, the animal world, and the outer worlds, as in the spiral galaxies. Some of these forms are shown in figure 3-6, DNA spiral and spiral cells of animals. And figure 3-7, DNA spiral and spiral galaxies, clockwise and anti-clockwise. J.D. Watson, co-discoverer of DNA structure, wrote that life is made to a pattern that lies half hidden in the cosmic chaos, of which I have earlier referred. According to Lyle Watson, this is another Watson who is a popular writer, Lyle Watson, life makes patterns out of patternless disorder. As we come to the end of this series of talks, we will realize, however, that all patterns of life are not only cosmic but also divinely ordered. Patterns are not the outcome of chance or accidental, as evolutionists say, life is the outcome of chance. The spiral pattern of the double helix can be abbreviated as the letter symbol S. That is the same as the S in the IHS of the church. This is the archetypal symbol of the coiled up psychic energy. The S symbol represents one turn of the double helix, which was earlier called the helixon. The helixon with its central axis can thus be represented as the archetypal symbol of the psyche, which is in fact the self, capital I, in the helix, that is capital S, as shown in the diagram in page figure on page 32, figure 3-8. The full symbol of the psyche with the soul and the self is shown below. That is in figure 39 on page 33, where the self is denoted by the archetypal symbol I, the soul is denoted by the letter symbol H, and the psyche by the letter symbol S. So, where the psyche is, there the soul is, and the self is. So, it is a triple unit. When we say the psyche, we must assume that the inner fields of life are present in the psyche. This is the universal archetype of the psyche, irrespective of whether it is linked to individual consciousness or super consciousness, as we have seen with the IHS symbol of the church. And this in IHS symbol, in fact, includes the I field of the logos, that is the self, the H field of the logos, that is the soul, and the S field of the logos, that is the psyche. So, the God force also upfields through these fields. These are only one of the seven fields through which the God force fields, as is the life force in the biosphere, to which I shall come later. The table below, that is table 3.1, common symbols of the self, soul and psyche in science and religion are shown. The overlapping relations of the above symbols of the psyche and the IHS symbols of the Christogram is indeed breathtaking, that brings science and religion together in a unique overlapping. This is quite unexpected in the light of the evolutionary scientists building up walls between science and religion. It is time that these walls are dismantled and these are brought together in intercourse. Thank you. In the light of the above observation, it can be inferred that the IHS symbol of the Christogram of the church indicate the patterns of life fields, that is self, soul and psyche, as I have already mentioned, through which the logos presents. Logos is God's word. The presence of these patterns in DNA reveals that physical life strictly partakes of the patterns of divine life. It thus reveals that the science of life of the church is science par excellence, and that church and science are not antitheses of each other. Thank you.